Good evening from San Ignacio Town. With the 9 o'clock news, I am Patrick Jones. In the headlines, mid-afternoon traffic accident reported on the Hummingbird Highway. Belize attends second meeting of the Multilateral Fruit Fly Commission held in Cancun, Mexico. And a new resource center is inaugurated in Arenal Village. Stay tuned for details of these and other stories coming up after these messages.
The Belize Tire Depot, your one-stop destination. What you will find is a first-class selection of solid, dependable, quality products from the names you can trust. We carry a full line of urea and SureTech tools and equipment to meet every need, from light maintenance around the house to heavy-duty fieldwork. Our tire workshop features the full array of Pirelli, Nexen, and Nankang tires for every vehicle and any terrain. Our trained technicians' number one priority is to ensure you and your family's safety and security on the road. It's all here at the Belize Tire Depot. From reliable equipment, world-class time-tested tires, to sturdy, durable tools. Merchandise that's built to last with quality guaranteed.
Are you always on the go? Tired of missing your favorite games while they're actually being played? Watch your games and sporting events live with Central TV and Internet's incredible MyTV. Simply log on to www.mitv.bz to get easy access to 25 channels, no matter where you are. With Central TV and Internet's MyTV, you're always in the game.
More vehicle owners are switching to the PureGuard line of motor oils, and with good reason. PureGuard comes in different grades and specifications. It carries the API certification and comes with the WestTrak stamp of approval, guaranteed to make your engine run cleaner and longer, up to 10,000 miles. With PureGuard motor oil, your engine will have less wear and tear, give you maximum performance on the road, and give your vehicle better fuel mileage.
PureGuard, good quality, affordable oil.
Distributed exclusively by WestTrak Limited, with branches in Spanish Lookout, Belmopan, Belize City, and Orange Walk Town.
Belize is in crisis and broken under the UDP. You have a voice. On Sunday, August the 2nd, join the People's United Party at the Teodosio Ochoa Park in San Ignacio at 3 p.m. to share your views with party leader Honorable Francis Fonseca. The People's United Party is the party that believes in real conversation. Join us in Cayo at the Teodosio Ochoa Park at 3 p.m. Power to the people.
We need a government that will listen and give we more. Hound salt is not a cure. It will keep
Here now is the news in details. Traffic was backed up this afternoon on the Hummingbird Highway due to a collision involving an SUV and a car. The incident happened near the junction at the entrance to Las Flores community. At least two persons were injured and taken to the Belmopan Hospital for treatment. Details of the incident are still sketchy at this time, and the police have not yet released any information on the incident. We will have an update as soon as more information becomes available. Belize had representation earlier this week at the second meeting of the Multilateral Fruit Fly Commission that was held in Cancun, Mexico. During the meeting, Belize's chief executive officer in the Ministry of Agriculture, Jose Alpuche, signed a fruit fly control cooperative agreement with the United States Department of Agriculture. According to a government press release, the cooperative agreement is signed annually between the parties to govern cooperation in the management of fruit fly pests of interest to protect crops in Belize and the United States. Efforts include the control and eradication of fruit fly pests, the management of an exotic fruit fly surveillance program, and the technical cooperation with respect to the management of fruit fly pests and related activities in Belize. The signing of the cooperative agreement comes at a time when officials recently announced the detection of the Mediterranean fruit fly at two locations in southern Belize. The Belize Agricultural Health Authority is currently conducting eradication activities in an effort to ensure that the pest does not become established in Belize. The United States Department of Agriculture has committed to providing Belize with $186,000 next year, which is already earmarked for medfly eradication activities and for the procurement of equipment, materials, and supplies. The government of Belize has allocated well over $500,000 in counterpart funding under the agreement, which will be used for salaries and operational expenses for the MedFly program. Accompanying CEO Alpuche to the Cancun meeting was the managing director of the Belize Agricultural Health Authority, Emir Cruz, and the national MedFly coordinator, Hernan Zetina. Over 400 residents of Arenal Village in the Cayo District stand to benefit from a new resource center. Inauguration of the new facility was held this morning. The newly constructed Arenal Resource Center, financed by the government of Belize at a total cost of $314,636, was made possible through a loan from the Caribbean Development Bank. According to an official release, the new resource center, which is designed to be used as a hurricane center, that should be a hurricane shelter, will significantly improve the quality of life of residents of Arenal Village and foster community development. It houses a computer lab complete with 5 computers and accessories, which will allow residents to be able to conduct research and have access to information technology. To assist with the effective running of the center, 8 persons from Arenal Village have received computer skills training. The project to build a new Arenal Village Resource Center was implemented by the Social Investment Fund. There was an armed robbery this morning at the First Caribbean International Bank branch at the San Cas Plaza in Belize City. Just before 9 o'clock this morning, a group of unmasked young men carrying weapons held up the bank, leaving customers and bank employees traumatized. Authorities have not revealed how much money was stolen in the robbery, and we understand that police have already captured 3 of the suspected bank robbers. Investigations by police are continuing. 4 former foreign ministers of Belize yesterday issued a joint press release on recent comments made by the Foreign Affairs Minister of Guatemala, Carlos Raul Morales, during his recent visit to Belize. And while Said Musa, Godfrey Smith, Amon Courtney, and Lisa Schumann chose to diplomatically point out that Morales got it all wrong when he talked about the confidence-building measures between Belize and Guatemala that were signed off on during the last Musa administration, our interpretation of 4 points made in the joint release by the former Belize foreign ministers is either that the Guatemalan foreign minister got it plain wrong, or he lied when he said during a joint press conference that a decision was taken to not increase military bases in the vicinity of the borders of Belize and Guatemala. The points made by Musa, who is a former two-time prime minister, Smith, Courtney, and Schumann reads as follows, quote, neither the 2000 nor the 2005 instruments on the confidence-building measures between Belize and Guatemala contain or state anything at all about military bases in either country. Two, no decision or agreement was ever made with Guatemala in the years 1998 to February 2008 by the government of Belize with regard to increasing or removing military bases in either Belize or Guatemala. Three, the mechanism to avoid incidents in the CBMs included the undertaking by Guatemala to dissuade its citizens from trying to settle in Belize, a mechanism to remove all illegal Guatemalan settlers in Belize, and a protocol for OAS verification where necessary. It never included any decision or directive in respect of any military base or any other manner of operation post, conservation post, or forward operating base. And four, there never was any commitment made between 1998 and 2008 by Guatemala to Belize in respect of its own military bases, and any decisions made by them with respect to the same were made unilaterally. End of quote. It is a stunning development in the discourse in the wake of the recent visit of the Guatemalan foreign minister and the apparent public relations campaign on taking Guatemala's unfounded claim to half of Belize's territory to the International Court of Justice for final resolution. You're watching the 9 o'clock news. Stay tuned for more of the day's stories right after these messages.
More vehicle owners are switching to the PureGuard line of motor oils, and with good reason. PureGuard comes in different grades and specifications. It carries the API certification and comes with the WestRock stamp of approval, guaranteed to make your engine run cleaner and longer, up to 10,000 miles. With PureGuard motor oil, your engine will have less wear and tear, give you maximum performance on the road, and give your vehicle better fuel mileage.
PureGuard, good quality, affordable oil.
Distributed exclusively by WestRock Limited, with branches in Spanish Lookout, Belmopan, Belize City, and Orange Walk Town.
Are you always on the go? Tired of missing your favorite games while they're actually being played? Watch your games and sporting events live with Central TV and Internet's incredible MyTV. Simply log on to www.mitv.bz to get easy access to 25 channels, no matter where you are. With Central TV and Internet's MyTV, you're always in the game.
You too can ride off into the sunset. Milon motorbikes are very affordable. There's a high availability for parts and a wide selection of models to choose from. My Milon, my bike. Available countrywide.
And I say, BUP have a plan to take back the wheel and lose it from the grips of this power greedy man, and it's time to make
Belize is in crisis and broken under the UDP. You have a voice. On Sunday, August the 2nd, join the People's United Party at the Teodosio Ochoa Party in San Ignacio at 3 p.m. to share your views with party leader, Honorable Francis Fonseca. The People's United Party is the party that believes in real conversation. Join us in Cayo at the Teodosio Ochoa Park at 3 p.m. Power to the people.
We need a government that will listen and give we more hands. Hope is not that yours.
Welcome back to the 9 o'clock news. The Belize Police Department has been given an incentive to work on catching persons responsible for a recent spike in cattle theft. The crime of cattle rustling has not been in the news frequently, but that does not mean that it is not happening. In fact, members of the Belize Livestock Producers Association say the situation is nearing epidemic proportions around the country, especially with the current rise in the price of beef. It has been a constant headache for farmers, and so they have now turned to the police for help. Through the BLPA, the farmers are offering a reward of $5,000 to the police department for the successful conviction of any person or persons caught stealing cattle. Cattle farmers are hoping that the offer of the reward for information leading to the successful conviction of cattle thieves will be incentive enough for persons to come forward with information and for the police to act quickly on whatever leads or information they receive. A memorandum of understanding detailing how the reward money will be dispersed was signed on Wednesday evening in Belmopan. Officer commanding Belmopan Police Superintendent Howell Gillett is optimistic that the reward being offered will help the police to achieve the objective of putting a serious dent into the practice of cattle rustling. Superintendent Gillett says that the reward offer is not only for police officers under his command, but for any officer countrywide that goes the extra mile to take down cattle rustlers. Two of Belize's popular archaeological sites, the Nohoc Chen Caves Branch in Belmopan and Lamanai in the Orange Walk District, are the latest locations to benefit from infrastructure upgrades under the EU-supported project Making Tourism Benefit Communities Adjacent to Archaeological Sites. The improvements were officially inaugurated and toured by the head of delegation of the European Union to Belize, Ambassador Paola Amadei, at ceremonies held on Wednesday, July 29th, and again on Friday, July 31st, respectively. Lamanai and Caves Branch are part of a comprehensive portfolio of 9 archaeological locations which have benefited from physical improvements including walking trails, bathroom facilities and signage, modernized information centers and craft markets. The sites have also benefited from health equipment and training for community residents adjacent to the sites in areas of artisanship, emergency response and certification as park rangers and tour guides to further enhance visitors' experience. The project has also introduced a visitor satisfaction survey to get feedback on services offered at the sites and launched a line of certified Belizean crafts under the unique Belize brand. The objective of the Tourism Benefit Communities Adjacent to Archaeological Sites project is to improve the overall service and quality of experience offered to tourists and local visitors at the sites, as well as increase employment opportunities to the communities around these sites. As a result of the project, 64 persons have been trained in small business product development, 42 in cave rescue, and 94 in site-specific guide training. A total of 200 persons, 87 women, and 113 men. The news on the national channel.
More vehicle owners are switching to the PureGuard line of motor oils, and with good reason. PureGuard comes in different grades and specifications. It carries the API certification and comes with the WestRock stamp of approval, guaranteed to make your engine run cleaner and longer, up to 10,000 miles. With PureGuard motor oil, your engine will have less wear and tear, give you maximum performance on the road, and give your vehicle better fuel mileage.
PureGuard, good quality, affordable oil.
Distributed exclusively by WestRock Limited, with branches in Spanish Lookout, Belmopan, Belize City, and Orange Walk Town.
Are you always on the go? Tired of missing your favorite games while they're actually being played? Watch your games and sporting events live with Central TV and Internet's incredible MyTV. Simply log on to www.mitv.bz to get easy access to 25 channels, no matter where you are. With Central TV and Internet's MyTV, you're always in the game.
You too can ride off into the sunset. Milon motorbikes are very affordable. There's a high availability for parts and a wide selection of models to choose from. My Milon, my bike. Available countrywide.
I say, P.U.P. have a plan, to take back the wheel and lose it from the grips of this power greedy man, and it's time to make...
Belize is in crisis and broken under the UDP. You have a voice. On Sunday, August the 2nd, join the People's United Party at the Teodosio Ochoa Park in San Ignacio at 3 p.m. to share your views with party leader, Honorable Francis Fonseca. The People's United Party is the party that believes in real conversation. Join us in Cayo at the Teodosio Ochoa Park at 3 p.m. Power to the people.
Turning now to weather news. Partly cloudy skies are in the forecast for tonight. Tomorrow will be mostly sunny. That is because generally fair conditions are currently dominating our weather heading into the weekend. Only isolated showers or isolated thunderstorms are expected. Winds over the open sea and along the coast will be easterly at 10 to 20 knots. The sea state will be choppy. Low temperatures tonight will range from 81 degrees Fahrenheit along the coast to 75 degrees Fahrenheit inland. It will be a cool 70 degrees Fahrenheit up in the hills. Tomorrow, temperatures will warm back up at 91 degrees Fahrenheit along the coast, 97 degrees Fahrenheit inland, and a warm 82 degrees Fahrenheit up at the exposed areas of the Mountain Pine Ridge and along the Maya Mountains in the south. The tides, there will be a high tide at 19 minutes to 11 o'clock tonight. A low tide follows at 4 minutes to 4 o'clock in the morning. The sun will rise at 5:32 tomorrow morning. The sun will set at 6:26 tomorrow evening. The extended forecast, valid through to Sunday afternoon, is for a few showers or thunderstorms to develop mainly over the south and coastal areas on Saturday night, then most areas on Sunday. And that is a look at the weather with information provided by forecaster Francisca Wellington at the Belize Weather Bureau. And now for the latest on the hurricane season, here is the tropical weather update.
Got a couple areas of possible tropical development in the Atlantic Ocean that we're going to be watching over the next couple of days. I know we've had a lot of action out in the Pacific, and we're really not in the core of Atlantic hurricane season yet. That would be more like September. But this time of year, it's a little bit early to see waves coming off the west coast of Africa. This is actually the first one that we've had so far this year. It's technically an invest now, giving it about a 20% chance of developing into something tropical over the next few days. And even if it does, you know, whether it affects land or not, that's still up in the air. So we're talking way down the road here. Nothing to be concerned about right now, just letting you know that we're watching it. Another spot that we've got our eye on, you remember that little area of low pressure that was over Florida earlier this week? Yeah, it was like that nonstop rain early in the week, midweek. Now that's an area of low pressure off the coast of the Carolinas that could also turn into something tropical. Nothing to be concerned about.
To end the news, here are the headlines again. Mid-afternoon traffic accident reported on the Hummingbird Highway. Belize attends a second meeting of the Multilateral Fruit Fly Commission held in Cancun, Mexico. And a new resource center is inaugurated in Arenal Village in the Cayo District. With the headlines, we end this edition of the 9 o'clock news. As we head out this Friday evening, we hope that you and your family will have a safe and an enjoyable weekend. Join us back here at the news desk on Monday for another broadcast. Thank you for watching. I am Patrick Jones. Have a good evening and a good night.